Hi everybody. This lecture is going to talk about imagery. So what is imagery anyway? Writers use imagery to convey feelings that are often difficult to describe in mere words. The writer paints a picture for you. They paint an image. Creating imagery involves using all of your senses: sight, sound, smell, taste, and touch. You can find imagery for a poem all around you. Let's look at an example of a poem that uses imagery. This is a poem by Robert Frost called Desert Places. Snow falling and night falling fast, oh fast. In a field I looked into going past, and the ground almost covered smooth in snow, but a few weeds and stubble showing last. The woods around it have it, it is theirs. All animals are smothered in their lairs. I am too absent-spirited to count. The loneliness includes me unawares. And lonely as it is, that loneliness will be more lonely ere it will be less. A blanker whiteness of benighted snow with no expression, nothing to express. They cannot scare me with their empty spaces, between stars, on stars where no human race is. I have it in me so much nearer home to scare myself with my own desert places. What is the feeling that you get when you read this poem? Think about that for just a moment. The poet is always trying to describe a feeling, such as loneliness. Rather than just tell you what loneliness feels like, the poet invokes that feeling from you with an image of something else. That is what Robert Frost has done here. Pause the video for a moment and let's practice. Flip through a magazine and find 5 images and or words that jump out at you. That means there may not be a reason why you choose a particular image or a particular word, but it's just an image or a word that made you stop and look at it for a second. That's what I mean by it jumps out at you. So you're going to look for images or words that maybe have some meaning for you. You may not even know what that meaning is yet. List the 5 objects that you chose and tell what each one means to you. In other words, what feelings do you get from the images? When we use imagery, we use all of our senses. Smell, sight, sound, taste, and touch. What poets are trying to do is create an image of a feeling. It's often a feeling that is so difficult to describe that the only way to describe it is by using an image. Using the senses allows the reader to see, to hear, to smell, to taste, and to feel the image that you are describing. Imagery tends to be very specific. It provokes a very specific image in the reader's mind, like Robert Frost did in his poem Desert Places. You might want to take a moment and look through this poem, where we've underlined all of the different senses being used. Another way to provide imagery in a poem is by using what we call descriptors. Descriptors are also called appositives, and these are phrases that simply add more information. They add a little bit more description to a simple sentence or phrase. Remember, poetry is all about using description to describe an emotion, and using descriptors will help you do just that. For example, we have a phrase, "She wanted to go to the ocean." Now, everyone is going to get a different picture of the ocean in their head, a different image. But if we add descriptors, then we're going to get much closer to the image that the poet, that the writer wants you to see. She wanted to go to the ocean, that beautiful deep blue water with seagulls flying low, catching jumping fish. Don't you see a totally different picture than you did from just the first phrase? Here you might want to stop again and practice using descriptors. Read each of the models I've provided and then come up with your own sentence by adding your own descriptors. Now it's time to try what you've learned about imagery by writing one or two or more poems. I've provided you with several exercises that you can download to practice writing poems with imagery. Don't worry about getting it perfect. You need to let go of perfection for now and get your ideas and images on that paper.